Okay, here we are again. Wrap this up. We can't deal with the Yahweh is so merciful that he is telling us, look, this is, you know, this is my commandment. It means this much to me not to, you should not do this. It's the first and second commandment not to worship these giant Asherah, these trees. These idols, idol worship, specifically in Hebrew, Asherah worship. He's jealous. The first thing he's jealous of is our love for these and our worshiping of these giant trees. And Satan specifically is a giant tree, as we saw in Ezekiel 31. He was this giant tree in Ezekiel 31 verse 7. All 37 speaks of Satan being this giant tree, the biggest tree in all the world, and that people worshipped it instead of Yahweh. Tree of knowledge of good and evil. Which was basically knowledge of good and evil was the knowing of going against what Yahweh asked them to do. It wasn't that the fruit was so great or that the evil was so bad of eating it or touching it or whatever. It was specifically the sin of going against the good and the righteous and the perfect creator of all things. Just stand against him. And to knowingly turn against Yahweh. So he shows mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. So if you keep his commandments and don't do this tree worship, if you become aware of what's really happening with these Asherahs and aware that they really did exist on the flat earth and that the Bible speaks of them over and over and over again, Asherah worship, the first and second commandment even, these idols, Satan himself, that if he will show mercy unto you, if you turn away from him, he will show mercy. Mercy means that he will overlook the sin that you've done. If you just, and to thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. Keep his commandments, that means wake up to what's going on. That's how big this is. This, you know, flat earth, no force thing. It's, you obtain the mercy of Yahweh by waking up to it and passing the information on, being a witness unto the truth of Yahweh's commandments. So, you know, you want the mercy of Yahweh? Do you want to be loved by him? To receive his mercy and his, to be blessed of him? In your life, in your walk, not like monetarily, as you can see here in my tiny shack, but to be blessed spiritually, which is beyond our lifetimes. It's eternally to receive all that Yahweh has, to be his children, to be heirs and his friend, the friend of Yeshua, his son. We not only disciples, but to be counted as his friends, as Yeshua Messiah said, I don't just count you as followers, but as my friends. Do you want to be the friend of Yahweh? The friend of I Am? The friend of the Creator of the universe? Do you want to live eternally? Stand up. It's worth whatever hardship that we may befall us, you know. He will stand for us if we stand for him. It's not going to be easy. I'm not telling you. You're not going to get a Cadillac or, you know, it's not happy, happy, joy, joy. It's not like these preachers who prophecy, you know, that you'll receive all this great stuff if you become a Christian. No, that's not what's really going on. But in eternity you shall have all things. You know, when Yeshua said, when they said, something about being as God, Yeshua didn't turn it down. He said, yeah, you know, yeah, you will be as God. You know, if you choose the right thing. And that's not an evil thing to say, because when he returns, we shall be like him in his likeness. And whose likeness was he? Like his father, Yahweh. So we become the children, to become the brother and the friend of Yeshua, is to become like Yahweh, like the Creator. So all these other religions that say you could become God and stuff, they're all liars. You can become like God. You can if you love mercy and righteousness, and you stand for the lowly and the poor, and you seek out good and humility, and do uprightness, and be a witness, and willing to take your cross. Well, I better close this up before the window of the camera closes all by itself. I love you. Stay in his word. In his word. His word is Yeshua. Every day in his word is a good day, because Yeshua Messiah is the living word.